Amy Krouse Rosenthal was a local author and filmmaker who touched so many with her heartbreaking essay in the New York Times titled, You May Want to Marry My Husband. It was read by over 5 million people. She wrote it just days before losing her battle to ovarian cancer, and that was back in 2017. Now her husband, Jason Rosenthal, is sharing his insight about love, loss, and living again in the new memoir. The book is called My Wife Said You May Want to Marry Me, and he joins us now via Zoom. Good morning, Jason.
Good morning.
Thank you for joining us. Yeah, you're a very sought-after interview, I hear, around here. So thank you for taking the time to spend it with us. I should also point out you are a very proud Chicagoan, and you have put up a nice tribute to your wife, Amy, in Lincoln Park, a yellow umbrella. Explain that to us.
Sure, yeah. I just had this idea after Amy died that I wanted her to live on in her hometown, Chicago. I really feel like she will go down as a Chicago icon. She contributed so much to this community.
She has a beautiful way with words. I reread the essay last night that she wrote to you. And the first thing was, what was your reaction after hearing those words about you?
It was just a beautiful, beautiful piece of prose and, of course, a love letter to me. But, you know, living with a writer, you never know what's going to happen. And I couldn't possibly imagine what did happen eventually.
Yeah. And you followed up a year later with an essay in the same column saying pretty much, my wife said you may want to marry me. And now you have created this book. Tell us about the book. I do want to warn people that in the beginning you say, hey, this is not going to be a sad story about my wife dying of ovarian cancer.
Yeah, you know, I think it's equal parts about life because, you know, she sort of catapulted me into this new place that I am. And it's a very, very, very sad story because Amy was a beautiful, beautiful human being. And I think that comes through in the book as well. But it's also about what we can do in the face of such a devastating loss and how humans are equipped to push through and get to the other side somehow with some resilience. And that's what I'm trying to do with my life.
Yeah, and it's so appropriate in this time because so many other people in this age of COVID-19 are dealing with loss and grief and trying to figure out how to move on. What kind of words can you share with them about that?
You know, I think the message is, you know, I have been through the devastating feeling of the worst type of loss that I can imagine. And I know many people are going through that today. And I think that with the perspective of a little bit of time, which I now have, I could encourage people that this will end at some point and we're going to get through it. It feels awful and you're going to be anxious and that's okay. Because eventually we will get back to some normalcy and find some joy in our lives.
I imagine having to relive this has to bring up a lot of emotions inside of you. How do you handle that? I mean, you would think that as time passes, it gets easier, but having experienced loss myself, I understand that that's not necessarily the case.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, grief, as you probably know, based on what you said, has really no timetable. But for me, as I have continued to, I've taken this and spoken about it publicly for now 3 years. And so writing the book was just another part of the process for me. And I write in the book that I like and appreciate returning to thinking about Amy because it now gives me quite a bit of joy.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Now let's also talk about, I don't want to miss this. You have the Amy Krouse Rosenthal Foundation, and there's a piece in there, and I found this line to be so telling. The only thing standing between early ovarian cancer detection and the ability for every child to read is the same thing, education. That is so powerful.
Thank you. Yeah, you know, one of the missions we have is to promote early detection of ovarian cancer. And we've just issued a grant to a physician to get that going now. And we've also have a mission of child literacy and are really proud to tell you that we've donated tens of thousands of books to kids in need all over this country.
Okay, and as I leave, I must warn everyone, this is a spoiler alert, so if you don't want to know how the book ends, turn off your TV or put it on mute for a second. you do end up finding love, because I imagine that's the question you get quite a bit. Have you found love, which Amy allowed you to do? She gave you a blank space to find, fill it in.
Yeah, you know, I mean, I've used the metaphor of that blank space for not just the current relationship I'm in, but for how I've chosen to live my life. And I can't thank Amy enough for that gift, because honestly, I don't know how I could have moved forward. And that's part of why I wrote this book, too, is to give others permission and say it's okay.
It's okay to move forward. Jason, thank you for sharing with us this morning.
Thanks so much for having me.
And best of luck in these times, these strange times, because I know you won't be able to go out on a book tour. So I'm quite sure you'll be reaching out to your readers as best you can. So we'll be looking out for that. As we mentioned, Jason has established a foundation in Amy's name, funding ovarian cancer research and children's literacy. It is the Amy Krouse Rosenthal Foundation. You can check out the website for more information, amykrouserosenthalfoundation.org.